get loose and produce.
Oh, what is going on, everybody? I hope your quarantine is going swell. I hope we're all doing good and staying sane. So today I'm gonna show you how to make some epic atmospheres using granular synthesis. I'm gonna show you how to turn a sound like this. Gonna love you more. Time is running out. Into this. And I'm also gonna show you a couple other quick tips. So let's get started. What granular synthesis does is that it takes a sample and it cuts it in a bunch of little pieces called grains, and then it plays back the pieces at different times or different pitches or different positions, overlapping or non-overlapping each other. It gets pretty technical, so I'm gonna skip over that, but there's a bunch of cool YouTube tutorials about it where you can learn everything about granular synthesis. So I'm gonna show a really cool free plugin that you can start using right now, whether you're on Mac or PC, and it's gonna change your life with atmospheric sounds. What you're gonna wanna do is go on Google and type in Cecilia 5 download, and you'll see Cecilia 5 by IX Sound Studios, and you're gonna download it. Then you're gonna load up the program, then you're gonna go to Modules, Time, Ultimate Grainer. Then you're gonna load up a sample, then you're gonna set the duration really high, and then you can mess around with all these different parameters and just test things out. The thing about granular synthesis is that you just spray and pray, baby. You spray and pray. You can play things back, or you can record them onto your hard drive and then bring it back into your DAW. So I just played around with a vocal sample, which sounds like this. Gonna love you more. Time is running out. And we got this out of it. Pretty fucking cool. Let's try out a different sample. Let's grab this random sample and bring it into Cecilia. Increase our duration, and let's just see how it sounds like. Whoa, that is seriously cool. Anyway, I'll leave that to you guys to play around with. Now that you know that this exists, I'm sure you can create some really cool stuff. Another technique you can do is to create cool percussive elements for your backing tracks for your drums. Here I got a loop of some keys jingling on a chain. What I like to do in these situations is to have some kind of place where I can record what I'm doing from the synth. In Ableton, you can just bounce it down to a track. In FL, you can just put up Edison on your master channel, hit record, and then just play stuff. And then it will record it into your Edison. Now we got all these different little transients that we can put in the back of our tracks. So once you have a little drum groove going, you can take those little things that we just recorded and sequence them out to support the drums. It adds variety to tracks and different interesting elements which people don't even realize that they like because they're in the background, keeping people entertained subconsciously. So now let's put all these elements together and see how we can use them in a track. You get the point. So hopefully Cecilia was a great find for you, and hopefully that was helpful to you. Thanks for tuning in, and I will see you soon. Stay safe, everybody.